may still be waiting for the next great video game film, but that hasn't stopped studios from giving more gaming properties the green light. Back in 2014, it was announced that Sonic the Hedgehog would get his own movie. And yesterday, it was announced that Sega and Sony Pictures would be making a live-action CG animation hybrid set for release in 2018. Dennis, will this film do justice to the world's fastest hedgehog?
Well, in terms of the style they're saying, this hybrid of live action and CG, I hate that style. I can't stand it. Okay, one movie didn't change my mind, but I actually liked that.
The shit rats?
No. Oh. Paddington was the movie that I was like, oh, that actually was good. But in general, yeah, the chipmunks, the Smurfs, didn't like Yogi Bear have one? They were all terrible. It creeps me out anytime I see that. And also, as someone who was a Sega fanboy in the 90s, and I love Sonic the Hedgehog, I don't understand why they're doing this, because Sonic lives in his own world. He's got Tails, Knuckles, Dr. Robotnik. He has a whole cast of characters. He has his old world. Why? The only reason you do a hybrid is if they're in the modern world of today. Why do that? It doesn't make any sense.
That's a great point. I loved the first Smurfs movie for about 3 minutes when we were in the Smurf village and we just got to be in their world, which is what I kind of wanted to get from Sonic the Hedgehog. It's a cool world. I remember playing that when I first got Sega Genesis. I popped in Sonic the Hedgehog and it was like Super Mario Brothers on steroids. That's what I wanted. They added Tails in there, and Tails was an even better addition to Sonic, unlike when they tried to throw Yoshi and Mario, and it was a complete disaster in my humble opinion. So for a movie coming out, I can't really get behind Sonic the Hedgehog as a live-action CG animation, because that seems to me like they're going to be marketing it clearly towards kids, not adults that are looking for nostalgia. It's going to be a children's kind of movie, a lot like the Smurfs, which does not work at all for an adult, or the Shit Rats, which do not work for an adult at all. It's simply to bring your kids to, and then the question becomes, okay, is Sonic the Hedgehog still a property that little kids grow up playing? I'm very out of touch with the video game universe, so I'm not sure if there are still Sonic games being made, or if it's going to be something they try to bring back into the public consciousness.
I hate this idea. I hate it. It's for all the reasons you're saying too, because, and the fact that it's Sony who is responsible for the Smurfs. I think that the problem is that these people never watched Wreck-It Ralph. Because if you watch Wreck-It Ralph, that's where Sonic, that type of atmosphere is where he should live. And I also hope that Roger Craig Smith is doing the voice, by the way, of Sonic. But
not Urkel. Urkel did the animated one.
I know Roger Craig Smith is Sonic, but the other thing that it could work if they don't try to do exactly what you're saying, just turn it full kiddish, and if they actually want to play a little bit more, and I don't want to say Roger Rabbit, because it doesn't really work in the Sonic universe, because there's not a lot of humans running around in Sonic's universe, and they're going to put it in the current, he's going to be in New York City, he's going to have to zoom over a taxi cab,
and there's going to be poop and fart jokes,
like he doesn't understand the world, he's in his world for the first 3 minutes just like Smurfs, then he comes into New York or San Francisco, whatever it is, and it's them going, oh, well, wouldn't it be so funny to see Sonic at an amusement park? No, it wouldn't. Put him in his regular atmosphere. It's the same thing that happened, even though different universes, Gem and the Holograms. It's the same type of thing. Gem and the Holograms had its audience, had a different core story, and they wanted, well, let's make it for the YouTube generation. The movie was in theaters for 3 weeks. Please stop
that
doing
long?
This.
It was in there that
maybe.
Long?
Maybe. Stop doing this.
I mean, I'd like to think Sonic the Hedgehog has a better fan base. It's a little more loyal than Gem and the Holograms, but I could be mistaken. Yeah. And you make a great point with the studio it's going to be at, is Sony Pictures, who is really looking for any sort of franchise tentpole they can get, whether it's kids coming into the theater or nostalgic adults. Either way, I think we need to see more before we can get any sort of confidence in this.
Hey, guys, if you like this clip, click here to watch the entire episode. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, because it'll help you stay up to date with all the stuff we've got going on here at Collider. Lighter.